So the Eccentric Family is a weird little show, and I wanted to make this spoiler-heavy video to talk about some of the more remarkable aspects of it. And let's start by talking about Ben 10. What a piece of work. I love how the show always keeps her mysterious. Sometimes the most polite and elegant woman you could ever meet, and sometimes a chilling embodiment of barely suppressed rage. For a while, she seems almost bipolar, and frankly, I was worried the show would basically write her off using gender stereotypes of the vain, emotional, hysterical woman. But then, so briefly, you could easily miss it. You see what happened to her. Benton was an ordinary, pretty teenager, spirited away by a Tengu, the professor, a sensei, and turned into something other. She's a kept woman, unapproachable by anyone except sensei, who fawns over her. And not far from the surface, she bitterly resents her position. She's the nightingale in the gilded cage, and every so often her anger at that cage bursts forth. That's why everyone fears her, and I think it's why she gets along so well with Yasaburo. He's so sympathetic to her position and doesn't treat her like a goddess, and she really responds to that, which makes her an excellent antagonist for the show. Her actions are unpredictable but not random, so the viewer has to work through the implications of a scene to figure out what she wants, and the characters have to scramble to find just the right thing to appease her and keep themselves out of a tanuki hot pot. Now, let's take a moment to talk about that. Holy crow, there's a constant threat that the protagonist might not just die, but be eaten, because that actually happened to his father. This felt really over the top to me, but the more I watched, the more I realized that the writer was partially making a point about eating meat, I think. From the human's point of view, a tanuki is no more intelligent than a rabbit. So, while it's an unusual animal to eat, it gives them no moral qualms. We, the viewers, know differently, so then why is it okay to eat rabbit or pork? That said, I do think that's a side point to the show's main theme, namely accepting your place in society. Yasaburo blithely helps the professor, Sensei, despite the latter's near constant verbal abuse of Tanuki. Because Tanuki serve Tengu and always have. Yasaburo's father allows himself to be eaten because that's a risk of being a Tanuki. You accept your role in society. But wait, you may say. Yasaburo fights back against being eaten, but he does that only when it's unjust. He even says at least one point that he'll probably end up in a hot pot someday. The Ebisugawa family tricked them into getting captured. So Yasaburo feels justified in escaping. Oh, one side note, you will find tanuki hot pot on the menu in many restaurants in Japan, but there's no tanuki in the dish. It's just a fanciful name, just like General Tso's chicken doesn't have any actual General Tso in it, or any connection to the historical General Tso, but anyway. I do want to applaud the staff in their handling of the climax, in which we get the culmination of many plot threads. Yashiro finally doing something brave, Yajiro bringing himself out of the well for the sake of his family, Yasaburo managing to protect his mother, and Yaichiro coming into his own as an important tanuki. It is hard in a show like this, it's about so many different plot threads, to handle them all in that ending, especially when you have a funnier, more light, upbeat comedic show. And he did, I think, a really impressive job of bringing all of those together. Finally, I wanted to hit on the subject of the family's father and his role in the show. It's always difficult to handle a storyline involving a deceased figure, especially a figure that characters really cared about. Clearly, Yasaburo's father is very important to that entire family, and you feel the loss of him throughout the entire show. And it's really remarkable that a show like this does such a good job of presenting that loss in a way that doesn't feel schmaltzy. It doesn't feel like they're pushing an agenda in the sense of saying how you should feel about that. This is a thing that happened. Their father died, and they've just had to deal with that, and they've dealt with that in very different ways. I also really appreciate that you see different ways of dealing with that grief, and that some of them are appropriate, and some of them are very much not. Being a frog at the bottom of a well for, you know, months is not a helpful and useful approach to things, but also, like, nobody's screaming at him. Everyone understands why he did that and why he's doing that. Even before they find out, you know, the circumstances around the death. So I really loved that and thought it was sensitively handled. So that's it. Those are my main thoughts on The Eccentric Family. I hope you found this useful. Please feel free to comment below with any of your deeper thoughts on the show and stuff you wanted to highlight about it. I'm sure there's more to talk about, but that's kind of what leapt out at me. And thank you for watching. Hope you will find more stuff to talk about in shows like The Eccentric Family, which has plenty to talk about. And fortunately, there's a season 2.